You want the smallest possible abutment. Go into the hex and into the screw. And in here you have also crazy angulation.
Hi, and welcome back to Uniqa Dental Show, where we discuss interesting cases and new procedures in the field of dentistry. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and send us your cases for us to review them. With us today is Dr. Yaniv. Hi.
Hi, how are you doing?
Amazing, how are you?
Great.
What case did you bring for us today?
Today, I brought a case that we saw as a laboratory. It's a case from a different doctor. We had three implants placed with impression taken, and the impression was sent to us. In here you can see three implants in the lower jaw, posterior area. In here you can see that the implants looked practically parallel, placed not bad. I don't think that they're new, because you can see that this is a little bit of bone absorption. I don't think that the implant was placed this way. But when you look in the mouth, when you look in the scan, in the impression itself, you see a very big problem. Because first of all, yeah, one of the implants is so buccally inclined.
Yeah, this angle is almost 90 degrees.
Exactly. It's a very big problem for every type of restoration that is possible to make. Because if you want to make cemented restoration, you don't have here space at all. The only option is to just leave this implant alone, like Brittany. And then don't restore on this implant, restore on those two.
Oh, and use that one implant as a...
No, for nothing.
Just forget.
Just forget about it. If you want to have cemented restoration, it's a problem because you want the smallest possible abutment. You want the smallest possible height of the abutment for the cementation, it's a problem. The higher the height of the abutment, the bigger the buccal bulge will be. So if you'll use regular abutment, your bridge will be so deformed, it will be so uncomfortable that there is no use at all in using this. In this case, this implant was used with the smallest multi-unit possible, with the smallest sleeve possible. And those two implants were with regular multi-units and regular sleeves. Now, not only that, you can see that these two screw channels are very small. Mm-hmm. And this screw channel is a little bit bigger.
Yeah.
That this is because in here you can see 1.5 millimeter sleeve. When you're using 1.5 millimeter sleeve, the screw is in the bridge itself. It's not in the sleeve. It's in the material of the bridge. So you can't have a floating screw in the bridge. You need to take the screw from outside, put in, and you need to close in here the screw. You can see that you don't even have place for the cap for the screw.
And it's a normal PMMA bridge.
No, it's a zirconia.
A zirconia bridge?
Yeah, it's the permanent bridge. Because it's small
it will
work.
Hold with all these gigantic holes. It won't the structure of the bridge itself.
The bridge will hold only on those two implants also. But the integrity, the chances for it to unscrew, for the screw loosening, are much smaller if you use three implants. Because you have three implants that each go to another direction, and the integrity is much better. So in this case, we did want to use this implant, and the only option that was possible is to use the smallest multi-unit with the smallest sleeve. The screw will be in the bridge itself. There is also almost no place to close with the cap this screw. What will hold the screw cap is the composite material that will go into the hex and into the screw. If you want to take out the screw, you probably would need to destroy the screw.
No.
Yeah, you don't have place at all. You can see this is the screw.
Yeah, yeah.
You don't have any walls to hold the cap.
Mm-hmm.
You can see these things also when you have almost no place
this
at all.
This angle is...
Yeah, you can see here, these two are placed this very buccally, this placed quite normal, and in here you have also crazy angulation. Everything in here was made on straight multi-units.
Not angulate
multi-units? No, no angulate multi-units at all.
Why? Because it will...
Because it's possible. When you can make on straight multi-units and you don't need to use angulate ones, it's much simpler to make the work. Angulate multi-units, if you wanted to use in this area angulate multi-unit, you don't have the option to use this. In here you can see the provisional bridge, the temporary one, not the permanent as we saw previously. If you want to use angulate multi-unit, the angulate multi-unit are bigger itself. You can't have zero height with the angulate multi-unit.
Yeah,
it's impossible.
There is not enough material as it is.
Yeah, there is not enough material as this. You want to make the bridge as stronger as possible. So in here we have this buccal inclined implant with the smallest multi-unit, with the smallest cap. Maybe in different case we wouldn't use this implant at all. We have this implant that is normal, and we have this implant that is very extremely angulated. We could have used straight one, but it's not trivial.
And it will hold and everything will be fixed.
Yeah, it will hold. There won't be a problem. You can see that the buccal bulge is not that big. There is a problem. You'll have a problem with the food residues that goes under this bulge. You'll have many different problems, but the question here is if you want to restore on this implant or not. If you want to restore, you have a solution. You have a way to restore. Maybe it's not the ideal way, but you can't make the ideal weight of restoration on not ideally placed implant. Mm-hmm. So you can see here that implants that were very poorly placed still can be restored quite good with a decent restoration, with a screw retained restoration, and it's not that difficult. Everything here was very easy.
For you?
For me, because I didn't do anything.
And this is a permanent bridge, and that's it?
This is the provisional bridge. Before we saw the permanent bridge from zirconia. The only difference is a little bit of colors. But there is no difference at all in the permanent and temporary bridge. The hole caps will be closed, and that's all. We finished everything with this small bridge, with these problematic implants. The distal implant with cemented restoration, for example, I'm not sure it's even possible to restore.
Do you have enough place here for cemented? Enough surface
in here
area?
You don't have enough height. In here, the angulation is too big, so you can't restore.
So what because of all the cement?
Yeah, it's a problem. It's maybe a case that will be very problematic for cemented restoration. And for screw retained restoration, it's also problematic because the implants are not positioned good. And still, you can see that we did had a good result, a fine result that will work.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you for being here today. And thank you for being here today. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, follow us, and send us your interesting cases for us to review. Have a great day or night. See you.
Goodbye.